Hi everyone, this is Keith Williams from Nomad Learning. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about something called virtual backgrounds in Zoom. The virtual background feature allows you to display an image as your background during a Zoom meeting, pretty much like what's behind me. This feature works best with a green screen and uniform lighting. So, you know, that allows Zoom to detect the difference between you and your background. On their website, they have full instructions on how to do this. But basically, you can also upload your own image as a virtual background. And there's no size restrictions when adding your own virtual background, but they recommend cropping the image to match the aspect ratio of your camera before uploading it. For example, if your camera is set to, you know, 16:9, an image of 1280 pixels by 720 pixels or 1920 pixels by 1080 pixels would work very well. So in order to enable your virtual background, you'd probably need to go to their website and have a look. And I will post the address for where that information is kept below this video. So, you know, you sign into your Zoom web portal as an administrator with the privileges to edit the account settings. And then you click on the account settings and then navigate around to what's called the virtual background option on the meetings tab and then verify that that setting's enabled. Now, if the setting is disabled, then you basically click on the status toggle to enable it. If a verification dialog box displays, you just choose turn on to verify the change. And then if you want to make that setting mandatory, you know, each time for all users in your account, you click the lock icon and then click lock to confirm the setting. Now, to get this to work, if you're using the system, you must log out of Zoom desktop client and then log back in again for this setting to take effect. If you want to then enable the virtual background feature inside Zoom itself, there is a setting at the bottom of the screen, which is next to where it says stop the video. You click on that, and then you'll see another option that says choose a virtual background. Now, in the virtual background settings, what happens is you have to choose a background or choose none. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to share my screen so you can see what I'm doing with the settings. So I'm going to share the screen, and I'm going to use the screen that you can see now. And hopefully, when I share that screen, you should now be seeing me in a small window and a larger window here. So here's my virtual background settings, and it's quite easy to change. So they come with a number of settings here. One looks like, you know, the Golden Gate Bridge. There's another one which looks like, I don't know, I'm in the reeds, and another one down here, which is a desktop type of environment. Now, you can change your virtual background to suit what you're doing at the time. So let's say, for example, you were working in a study and you were trying to teach someone, I don't know, about books. As you can see behind me, there's lots of books. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop sharing my virtual background screen picture. And now we're going to come back to the video itself. And as you can see behind me, you know, I can turn around completely. And this looks like as if I'm actually in a book room with books up on shelves and various things going on. So you can change the meaning of your video very, very quickly to have a different background. So virtual backgrounds, really, really useful feature. And like I say, Zoom is becoming a very, very good tool to use for video conferencing. The free version is basically free forever. And virtual background has been added as a feature not all that long ago, so you can do that yourself. This is Keith Williams from Nomad Learning. I hope that you've learned something here about virtual backgrounds today. Let me know in the comments below what do you think of virtual backgrounds and how you might be able to use them with Zoom. Thanks for watching.